Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is another one of those mini tutorials where I'll teach you how to get colors for your projects. Okay, so let's just get started. Open your browser. It could be Chrome or Safari, it does not matter. Let's go to Adobe Color. That's color.adobe.com. Okay, so once you're in here, you need to sign into this account. And once you do that, you can click on Explore. So you can see a lot of palettes right here or color themes, and you can actually save these, but you can also browse them as most popular or most used or random, or you can also choose which are the newest ones from here. So you can do most popular and then look for a palette that you think looks really pretty. So I'm just gonna go ahead and just scroll down a bit, and I think this one looks pretty nice, and I think I might use it in one of my projects. So I'm just gonna go here and I'm going to click on Save. This window pops up. You can choose it and make it anything you want. Let's just say Tutorial 1. And then you can choose your cloud library. Here you can choose any of the libraries that you want. What I mean by this is if you go to your Illustrator, here you can see when you click on Libraries, Libraries, Window, and then Libraries. So here, if you scroll down, you can see a lot of different libraries that you have. So this is basically, you can create different libraries depending on the project that you're working, or you can make one basic library kind of thing. So I have some pastel shades. I don't know why I've named, S is missing here, but that's typical me, and I never change it. So some pastel shades, and then you can go to my library where I usually dump in all my color themes. So okay, so I'm just going to keep it as my library. If you click on this, you can see all other libraries, but let me choose my library. And then you can add certain tags to this. Like if you're creating your own palette and you are a theme, color theme, and you want to put it out there for other people to use, you can add some tags in here. It's really good. And you can click on publish this theme to explore. So this particular color theme was published to explore, and that's why you can see it. So but yeah, let's just leave it blank. We don't want to save this because it is something that we are taking from someone else. So let's just click on save, and then this page pops up. So here there are a lot of options right here. You can edit a copy. So if you click on that, it'll let you choose your own color themes. So this is like the base theme, but I want to modify it a little bit. I could just use these color wheels to move around or modify it however I want, or I could also use these things to modify it. Or if I have a hex code of some other color which I think would really go with this theme, I could just bring that in and paste it here, and that would be all right. And then I can click on save color scheme. But right now I don't want to save it because I modified something and I don't want to do that. So I'm just going to keep it at this. So let's just go back to our Illustrator. And here you can see the recent color scheme that we, a color theme that we imported. If you cannot see the recent color theme, you'll have to click on this on the cloud. So that will sync up your library. So basically for this, you have to be logged into your Adobe account. Otherwise, it would not work. So coming back to the Adobe library here, it's okay if you have a color wheel. There's also an important thing called as import image. So if you click on that, you can basically import any image that you want. I'm just going to choose this image because I can and click open. And now it'll bring up a color theme here, but it's not necessary that you have to stick to it. So what you can do is you can move these things around, for example, like this, and make your own palette. So if you have a wedding invitation or something that you have to design, and you have a, you know, a theme about the flowers that's going to be used in the wedding or something like that, then you can import that image and use that image to create a color palette for your wedding invitation sets. So this is something which you use in such scenarios, and it's pretty amazing actually that you can make your own sets out of this. And once you have everything ready, you can just click on save color theme. Okay, and then it'll pop up right here. If you don't want something, you can just right click and say delete. And if you want to use these color themes, it's as simple as that. Draw something out and then just use the color. That brings us to the end of this tutorial, and I hope you liked it. If you did, give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. And also hit the bell button so that you get notified every time I post a new video. I guess I'll see you next week then. Bye-bye.